one?
A shorter ramp?
Well, this is okay.
Oh, okay. It's up to you.
Thank you. Excuse me, I wanted to see Tom Morrow and stuff in this thing.
Oh, he's not around with us anymore. He's actually moved over to Florida.
Well, what's taking his place, if anything?
Nothing at the moment.
So you just go up here rather than in here?
You go up to the second floor, and there's an elevator that can take you to the bottom floor. So I can let you
in here. No entrance from there anymore.
That's our exit. Yeah, if you'd like to enter from the bottom floor, I can get you in that way.
Let's go. Yeah, let's do it. Let's do that.
Yes?
Yes, please.
Head on down this way.
Since I went up there and... Let's go this way.
Head on in.
path up this ramp. When you reach the top, make a left-hand turn.
Thank you. Tom Morrow.
Yeah, we don't have Tom Morrow anymore.
That's too bad.
I don't know why, though.
I thought they had updated him or something.
No, they did a lot of changes in the building, and that was one of them, all at the same time.
Feels nice and cool in here and quiet.
How's it going?
Fine.
Just take a little tour?
Yeah.
There you go.
They must be having new plans for this. This is that old house. They're supposed to use the building. for a cheeseburger?
Darling children were visited by Peter Pan and Tinkerbell. Now, Peter Pan and Tinkerbell were visiting on this particular night because they were looking for something. They were looking for Peter Pan's lost shadow. You see, he accidentally left it there the night before when he was secretly lifting it. Story time. Hi, Tink. Tinkerbell. Oh, Tink, did you find the shadow? Oh, sorry. Well, I guess they couldn't find the shadow anywhere. So they decided to wake up the smartest one they knew, Wendy. And Peter said, Wendy, Wendy, I'm looking for my lost shadow. Can you please help me find it? And she said, oh, my Peter, I've been waiting for you. I put your shadow in my dresser drawer. Like that. Oh, we got lots of dresser drawers in this room. I think one of them's got a shadow in it. I think that one's got a shadow. Oh, it does. Will someone open up the dresser drawer and let the shadow out so we can finish the story? All right, the shadow is safe, and Peter chased it all around the room before he finally nabbed it behind the easy chair. That's smart, Wendy. She knew what to do. She sewed the shadow on Peter's foot so it couldn't get loose. He was so grateful, he shouted, everyone ready to go to Neverland? And of course they were. So he sprinkled down the pixie dust, told him a thing, happy thoughts. Before they knew it, they were airborne. Come on, everybody. Here we go. Off to Neverland. And out the window, they flew into the night sky. Now, if you've never flown all by yourself before, it can definitely take some getting used to. It's not that easy at first. They needed a lot of practice. But for Wendy, Michael, and John, it was the most wonderful experience they ever had. Poor Nana, she was not too pleased. Well, they floated off. Diving, loop-de-loop, follow the leader all the way to Neverland. Oh, Anita, it's more beautiful than I ever imagined, said Wendy. And it was, with dazzling rainbows, deep dark forests, an Indian camp, a mermaid lagoon, and of course, the fearsome pirate ship, the Jolly Roger. Look out, said Peter Pan, and those pirates began to shoot at them with their cannonballs. Now hold on, pirates, do me a favor. We'll start with you, and all you have to do is aim the cannon where you want to shoot. We're starting with this lovely lady here. Go ahead, aim the cannon. Who are you most upset with today? I'm just kidding. Ready, aim, fire! All right, let's let the next pirate right here try. Tink, go ahead, aim it. Fire at Will. Oh, I hope your name's not Will over there. Let someone else try it, the Cheshire Cat hat. Go ahead, fire away. All right, let's let the gentleman pirate try. Fire, sir! Awesome! One more pirate back there in the Mickey shirt. Fire away!
Oh, good job. Oh, I hope you can get him.
Where are you, Peter Pan? He burst through the clouds and began a duel to the deck with the evil Captain Hook.
It was a fearsome sight with the slashing of sails and the clashing of swords,
the cutting of ropes, the chopping of mustaches, and the mincing of words. Well, Captain Hook was made of the extreme, but there was one thing that shimmered his timbers. Anyone know what it was? It was the crocodile, of course, and he was patiently waiting for his snack down below. And like all heroes, brave and true, Peter Pan vanquished the evil Captain Hook. Last he saw him, oh, he was desperately trying to avoid being a crocodile's dinner. Now, Peter Pan was Captain Pan, and the Jolly With a lot of help from Tinkerbell's pixie dust, that pirate ship began to float up through the air, all the way back to their cozy little nursery in Bloomsbury. You know what? They made it home just in time to catch another story all about Neverland. You bet Peter Pan was somewhere close by. Thank you so much for helping me with the story. And now that it's all done, we have one more job to do. Will you help me? Okay, everyone, gonna grab you some more pixie dust, okay? And if you're just joining
joining us, we're getting some pixie dust and we're going to count to three and blow it everywhere. Ready? Okay, one, two, three. All right. Thank you so much for helping once again. And unfortunately, we're only doing Peter Pan in this room today. But if you want to see more cool technology, you can cruise around the house, play with all the stuff. In the next room along the curb will be the daughter's room. You can play some more Xbox Kinect and Zooms and the home automation system and much, much more. So have a great time. And you're welcome. If you have any questions, look for us in a yellow soccer jersey. See you in the future, guys.
Thanks. You're welcome. Do you also do the putting on the dress and the girls room over there?
Unfortunately, that technology has been dismantled because they're featuring different technology in that room, the Xbox Kinect and such.
Okay.
Have a great time.
Thank you very much.
Welcome.
I appreciate it.
My pleasure.
You were very good.
Thank you.
You know what time it is? You like that bed, eh? Does anybody know what time it is?
Probably.
You know what time it is?
1:20.
1:20, thank you.
How did the
lights go on? Lights on.